So, welcome to the second day of the 7th Jack and Kay Conference. I hope you have used the small break for getting some coffee or whatever. If you have taken part in the tech session, if you're popped new in, welcome to the conference day, to the second day. If you happen to come from YouTube, we encourage you to switch over to our own framework, because then you can take part at the polls and at the Q&A. Simply go to conference.checkmk.com. You will find this link also in the video description. Then you can take part at the chat, at the polls, and at the Q&A. So, yesterday was much about the current situation of CheckMK, and today is all about the future. So we have five interesting presentations. The first of one will be held by myself about the user interface. We will later talk about the roadmap, about cloud monitoring, and other interesting stuff. So this day, we will do lots of votes. That means you can take active part. Actually, in the development of CheckMK, we are very eager to get your feedback on which things we should put all our effort in, our work in, what features are very important for you, on which areas we should work hardest. So, just for trying out the voting system, I'll launch a small vote. In your framework, you should have a tab for the votes, and a vote should pop up. And the first vote that I will make is just as a test. If you like the dark user interface, or the light one, or the blue one, and please vote now, and then I'll see, okay, we have already 30 votes, 40 votes. One word maybe to the technical, we have a latency of about 6 seconds. So if I start the vote, my speech will be 6 seconds later. So you will be basically 6 seconds ahead of the vote. So don't get confused if the vote pops in too early or pops out too late. That shouldn't be a problem. So, yeah, nice result. We already have 180 votes. And let's try showing the votes to everyone. So the outcome this time is 70% roughly like the dark user interface, 18% like the light one, and we have still 10% like the blue user interface, which was the first one I've created together with a designer long years ago. I'm not sure if it's 10 years. It's really very long, and yeah, I like the blue, but everyone is going black and white now, and personally, I prefer the black user interface in these days. Okay, so we have worked on a lot of things. Just as a reminder, these are some of the new dashboard elements. You have seen them yesterday in the tech session, also in the state of the CheckMK. So I won't go into any more detail about these elements. But we already haven't stopped development. We are thinking about new things. So here is a small collection of new dashboard elements which we are planning to build. These are very simple elements, but I think they have been missing. For example, a very simple element that just shows the state of a host or a service. Or if you have a collection of hosts and services, you can show how many of these are OK and how many are not OK. Also, this hexagon is currently only working for hosts and services. And as you all know, with the event console, we have a third kind of object in the monitoring, which is event monitoring. Then if you use that, you will be interested in the number of currently open events in different states. And this will be represented by this third hexagon for the main dashboard. Also, there's the idea of adding information about the inventory. So you might already use the hard and soft inventory of CheckMK. So this inventory can find out many interesting things about your host. And you could, or you probably will be able to display this information on a dashboard. For example, the number of CPUs or network interfaces or whatever. There are really very, very much information. There's also application-specific information in the inventory. If you haven't checked out the host and service inventory, please do it. Have a look at the user manual. It's basically very simple. You need one agent plugin deployed on your Linux or Windows server, And then you get lots of more interesting information about your systems. So we already have some more ideas of what we can put on dashboards. And here's a small collection what could possibly be done. So this is not yet existing. We also haven't yet decided what to do. And this is the time we will start a small poll. So I already will launch the poll now. And then I explain a bit what all this is about. So the first new dashboard element could be a so-called donut. It's a circle. It's an alternative to the gauge, but the difference is that it would be ideal for metrics that together form a kind of 100%. For example, if you have user system and I/O weight from the CPU utilization, they could be displayed as a donut very nicely. Or maybe the usage of TCP connections, where you have different connection states and all together make up 100%, and these could be displayed in such a kind of circle. Then, you know, we have these hexagons, and the hexagons display hosts. And there would be an idea to let you group the hexagons by different things. For example, use a host tag and create one group of one visual group of hexagons for each host tag. These examples here do not show the actual outcome. It's just screenshots of the current hexagons. But you would see groups, different sizes, and one group for tag 1, the other group for tag 2, and so on, maybe with labels. This would be an enhancement of this hexagon element. Then there's the idea of using a bar chart for time series graphs. Basically, it's just a different kind of visualization. It's no new data. It's just a kind of compressed information of a time series data. And then the fourth idea would be to have maps inside the dashboard. It can already be done with some hacks and so on to add NugWiz maps to the dashboard, but we could make it available for everyone so that you can very easily add maps to a dashboard. And of course, these maps are not static. They have, for example, hosts. You already in JackMK can put coordinates to your hosts, so you would have a geometrical map. You can see what the state of certain locations is, or abstract diagrams can also be done here. So let's have a look at the results. So you should now be able to see the results yourselves. And what's interesting for me that the time series bar chart has somehow won this vote. Because it doesn't show any new information, but it shows compressed information. That's maybe very helpful. Also, of course, is the idea that if you click on such a bar, that you get a kind of drill down for this certain time period. Okay, so let's have a look at the topic application-specific dashboards. We are already working on a dashboard which looks like this. It's a dashboard about a Linux server. And so we are planning to make dashboards for various applications so that if you have a host that's running a certain application, a dashboard will be available. So this comes with something implicit, and that's conditional dashboards. So if you have a dashboard for Linux host, it wouldn't be useful to show that for example, for a switch. So introducing application-specific dashboards will also introduce the possibility that a dashboard can get conditions. These conditions will be stated maybe with labels, with tags, with filters, whatever, so that you can say, if this host is a Linux host, automatically you will see a Linux-specific dashboard. And of course, there are many other applications. So the next poll is about the question, what kind of application-specific dashboards you would prefer? So for example, in the poll, we have We have Linux, Windows, vSphere, Docker, Kubernetes, Oracle, MySQL, certain AWS application type dashboards, Azure, and so on. If you have applications that are not listed here, maybe you can use our forum or the Slack to make further proposals. So for us, it's very interesting, of course, where we should put our effort in for different applications. And the Linux application dashboard is anyway will come. The nice thing is we know very much about Linux, and everyone running CheckMK has Linux, so this, of course, makes sense. And let's have a look at the polls, the outcomes. So there's a clear favorite here, and that's vSphere. At least every fourth of you has voted in favor of vSphere, so it's not very astonishing. So we probably create some dashboards, maybe not just one. Maybe it's a kind of hierarchical structure. We have one dashboard as an overview of a complete vSphere cluster, and maybe a second dashboard for each ESX host or whatever. We will see. Kubernetes is also very strong. Of course, Linux and Windows, Docker, Oracle, and yeah, these seem to be the winners right now. Yeah, then when let's keep it dashboards. We have another idea, and what you see here is something. The ones of you who were in the tech session yesterday, we built such a dashboard here. So the idea is that this is basically not a dashboard. This is the normal services view of a host. But at the top, there's a bar, or let's call it a ribbon, which is actually a small dashboard, which is showing additional information for this Linux host here. So the idea would basically be three things. First thing is we make small host-specific dashboards for various host types, which are just like this ribbon. Maybe one for Linux, maybe one for Windows, maybe one for a Switch, Oracle host, and so on. The second is that these dashboards have conditions. So the Linux ribbon will only be shown if there's a certain host label, operating system Linux. Then you would be able to fold these small ribbons. And since they're dashboards, you could edit them in the dashboard editor and create your own versions of it. Also create completely new ribbons or mini dashboards if you like. And the nice thing is that that would enrich your normal, let's call it home page of a view. So the next poll is very simple. It's just the question if you like this idea, if you think maybe it would help or you don't care. So we will have lots of polls like these here today. These you like the idea. If you always vote in favor of like the idea, then you are kind of wasting your energy. So for these ideas that you think are not useful for you, better vote don't bother, because then we won't waste any effort in that specific topic. Yeah. And let's have a look at the results. And as I guessed myself, we have at least 2/3 of the people, 62%, which are really liking the idea. I think it's a great addition for CheckMK. It makes the navigation, everything much more efficient and improve the overall user experience. So the idea would be to have conditions in dashboards used as kind of ribbons, so the dashboards would have a fixed height. That would be a property a dashboard can have, that it has a fixed height and it has conditions. And then for each view, you could have a list of dashboards that this view will put on top of itself. So that will be, of course, so flexible that you can create your own mini dashboards if you like. Another thing that we came up with is the question of the editing of dashboard elements. So if you look at this, we have, you know, this dialogue for styling one of the new gauges, for example. We have seen that in our tech session. Sometimes you need many turnarounds, click something, save, and look how it looks like, go back, and so on. So the idea would be to have a kind of preview. So if you change something in the dialogue, you would get directly a preview how that element would look like. So the vote is just a question, do you think this is useful, or do we waste our time if we implement such a feature? I'm not really sure how difficult it is to make such a thing, but looks for me that it's very modern to have such a preview. So let's have a look at your meaning to that topic. And yeah, it's again 60% in favor of this. So at the end of this session, we will have another vote where you can weight where these all ideas are weighted against each other. So I'm curious of the outcome of that vote. Okay, so let's go a step beyond. Now is an idea that already popped up yesterday by questions from you. So if I create such great dashboards, wouldn't it be nice to share them either on the CheckMK exchange or maybe in your own company? And the solution, of course, the CheckMK solution, of course, would be that you could be able to package those dashboards into an MKP, and that would be able to, of course, upload it to the exchange, and of course, you would be able to download dashboards of other guys from the exchange, which is even more useful. And you could share that dashboards also in your environment and distribute them and so on. So, yeah, that I don't think it's too hard to implement for us. So, and let's have a look at the votes. And this time it's even more clear. So, 70% of you think that's a good idea to package dashboards. I think it's very natural to have the possibility to do this. So, I'm also in favor of that. That feature. Yes, and now comes something a bit more sophisticated. You know, we have dashboards which are host specific. We have seen that yesterday in the tech session. We have spoken about, for example, a Linux dashboard. In some cases, you have several instances of an application on a host. For example, you could have several Oracle instances on an Oracle server. Or, of course, you have multiple CheckMK instances on a CheckMK server. So, assume you want to create a nice dashboard about one Oracle instance. You can do that. But the hard thing is that you would have to nail down the name of the instance in the dashboard. And if you have 50 Oracle instances in one server, you surely don't want to create 50 copies of the same dashboard. So what we would need here is a kind of instance-specific dashboard. It's much like the host-specific dashboard, but in addition to the host, you would need the name of the Oracle instance or the name of the CheckMK site. So we would need a mechanism for having that variable in a dashboard. And the next step would be to have a selection list so that you can choose from all the Oracle instances of one host for showing the dashboard. So that would be the question, should we invest in such a thing like instance-specific dashboards in general? And of course, maybe then implement some instance-specific dashboards ourselves for certain applications. But this vote is about should we implement the concept of instance-specific dashboards in CheckMK. And looks like this time it's not so clear, so let's have a look at the votes. So yeah, it's really head-to-head, so 40% of you think it's a good idea, 40% don't care, okay, 25% said okay. So it's a bit in favor of this feature, but most users are in favor of new features anyway, so Let's see. I believe it's a bit more complicated to implement that feature than, for example, the conditional dashboards. But maybe I'm wrong here. The next topic doesn't have to do directly with the dashboards as such, but are also important in the context of dashboards, and it's about filtering. As you know, we have introduced the host labels and service labels, and currently, if you create a filter, you just can basically use an AND combination of these filters, of these labels. You say, select all hosts that have these certain labels, have all of them. And of course, we could make this more flexible and add things like OR negations of labels. And the option B, as an alternative, would be to have more complex filters being saved. So, for example, you collect several host filters about host tags, about labels, about the states, and so on, and then you could save all these filters with their actual values and give them a name, like a bookmark, and use that name in further situations, a bit like the predefined conditions, so that you can kind of create your standard filter settings and reuse them at various places. That would be the option B. Of course, we could implement both of that, but this vote, we want to see which of that is for you more useful. The more flexible label filtering or the ability to save filter structures as bookmarks. And yeah, here the outcome is clear in favor of the labels, which anyway might be less effort to implement. So that's a very interesting feedback. I generally think labels are much more and more useful in future. So might be a good idea to invest some time into the labels. So let's have a look at the next topic, the time series graphs. Everybody likes the graphs, and we have lots of graphing in CheckMK. And as you know, the graphing engine in CheckMK is self-implemented. We haven't embedded any other tool. We already have replaced the PNP for Nuggets in the raw edition with our own metric system, with our own graphing system. Many people say, why we simply use Grafana for that. The answer is we use Grafana, but it's better to have something implemented right into CheckMK, because we can present the right graphs and right metrics at the right situations, because we have some knowledge about services, about the metrics. We have predefined templates. We know that certain metrics belong together, can be stacked, and that's some information that gets lost if you simply export these graphs to a third-party tool. So we have our own graphing system. But of course, we can improve that in many directions. So we have found three different areas where we could improve our graphing system. Idea A would be to have the feature to set annotations. You have a look at the graph, you find some interesting peak or something, and maybe you already know something about that peak, because that peak was a reboot of a server or something happened. Then you could create an annotation, right-click on the peak and write a label to it so that other users can see what was there, or maybe for you as a reference for later. And my idea would be to have also a property of this annotation, that you can say this annotation is just for this single graph, or it's for all graphs of that service, or maybe it's for all graphs of the host, because sometimes several services of a host have... Oh, I have the wrong poll. Okay. Don't mind. I finished this. So the annotations would have a scope between single graph, single service for one host or global. This is the vote of the time series graphs improvement. I see I've skipped a vote. We already went to the vote about the general features as such. I let run the vote for a while because this one that's currently running, I've skipped one. We ask which of all these features is the most important for you. So I'll give you some time for this vote. So the question in these votes are, should we have focus on more dashboard elements or should we take focus on application-specific dashboards? Is it important to have this host view dashboard or the preview of the dashboard elements, the packaging of dashboards, instance-specific dashboards, improve the power of filters, which we have already discussed, time series graph improvement, this is the one I've skipped, I will do later, and a last idea would be to have a URL for externally sharing dashboard. That means if you have a dashboard, you would have a button or menu entry called share, then you would get a URL, can copy them somewhere, send it via email, and the one that clicks on the URL would see the dashboard but wouldn't have any permissions to change anything or go anywhere else. So it would be a very easy and secure and safe way to share the contents of a dashboard. You also could use that for having that dashboard displayed on a wall screen where no user is able to authenticate. So that link, of course, would work without user authentication. That's the idea of the URL for externally sharing dashboards. And yeah, we have 260 results already. So let's have a look at the outcome of that vote. It's still running, so you can still vote, but I will discuss anyway. So the interesting thing is this URL, after I've explained it, has made it to place one, which I think is a very good idea. Also, it was asked a couple of times yesterday, how can I externalize a dashboard? How can I share that on a screen or things like that? And that would be definitely possible with that. Then we have four items that are similar, all in the 30s, more dashboard elements, application-specific dashboards, package dashboards in MKPs, and improve the power of filters. So more dashboard elements will sure come. And I guess in every CheckMK version, we will improve something here. Also, the application dashboards, application-specific dashboards, is something, a process that we started and that we are going to continue from version to version. And yeah, the packaging of dashboards, I think, makes sense as we have more and more and more and better dashboards. So I like this outcome. We also already see the instance-specific dashboards probably will not make it into the 2.1 because you voted a bit against it. Maybe it comes in future, but we need to think about how we get an easy solution for that. So let's come back to the time series improvements. Let's show the slide again. So the first idea would be to have an annotation at a specific point of time in the graph. Then, of course, there's an option to have an overall performance gain. The graphing. The graphing, of course, takes much CPU power. I start the poll already. And the question is, should we invest time to make graphing faster for you, faster feedback? So if you scroll back and forth, if you change the time frame and so on, we could do this by incremental updates while zooming. We could try something with caching and so on and so on. So general question, improve the performance of the graphing, or do you think it's fast enough? And the option C would be improve the usability. And one thing that I myself struggled with a couple of times is the zooming. So you currently zoom in with the mouse wheel, but we could change that to a kind of drag, a kind of area selection. So you see an interesting area, you draw a frame around it, and once you release the mouse, you get zoomed in. I think that's a way many tools do that for a good reason. Also, I think it would be faster because we just would need one update and not for every click of the mouse wheel. So this would be the main improvement in option C, this zooming. And let's have a look at the polls. So, nice thing, 60% of you are very happy, which is, of course, nice. And I think the votes are in favor of usability, so especially the zooming. And yes, I think it's a good idea to improve in that way. Also, I personally always like a fast feedback, so I guess performance improvement will be done anyway from time to time. Okay, so have a look. We have done this overall working. And yeah, then I want to show you a couple of things where we are currently working on. So if you look at this page, you might discover it as the service configuration or service discovery page. This is a very important page, also a very complicated page. It lists many services. Also, the discovered host labels are shown here. And we had many discussions. We had a couple of workshops how to improve that page. So one of the ideas to have kind of a box with the suggested actions, which you see on top. And then, for example, in this example, we have 9 vanished services and 1 undecided service. And with 1 click of the button, you can apply all this. It's a bit of this button monitor undecided and remove vanished services in once, but you get a kind of summary information at the top of the page. And if you are interested in details, you would scroll down and can see all of these things. That's one of the page we are currently working on. Also, we have ideas of the add host page. We have the idea that you have a kind of, instead of getting the complex dialog where you have to enter the IP address and all that stuff, that we just make 1 simple text entry as an option to that, as an alternative way, where you could type in an IP address or a host name, press enter, and then CheckMK will determine the IP address or the host name, and then we'll try out, is there SNMP installed in the system? Is the CheckMK agent available on the system? And then suggest the basic settings of the host, the type of agent, and so on. That especially would improve the thing for beginners, but also would make the workflow of adding hosts faster for everyone. That's something we are currently working on. Also, we have 1 idea which I want to show you now. It has to do with another very prominent page, the activate changes. As you all know, CheckMK has 2 worlds. The one is the world of monitoring, the other world is the world of the configuration. And these worlds represent 2 phases in time. So you can have a configuration that's not the same as the actual monitoring because you prepare changes in the configuration. And when you're done with your jobs, you can activate them, go to the activate changes page, press a button, get kind of nasty progress bars, a page that's popping back and forth, and then you have completely lost the context where you actually were. So this workflow is not very nice. So we had the idea of creating a workflow, as you can see in this picture, where when you press the changes button at the top right of the page, you will get a kind of pop-up on the right where you see an icon for every site that's affected by that change and a button for activating the changes, and then you would see a progress right in these hexagons and also get an error if the activation has changed, has failed on a site. And of course, you could press the details button, and that would bring you back right back to the original activate changes page as you know it from today. But you wouldn't have to leave the page where you are currently are. So after activating the change, you are still on this page and can do further tasks, or you have suggested next steps, as you can see on the bottom right. So for example, if your change consists of adding 3 hosts, you have links to go to these hosts directly in the monitoring. So that's something we are working on. And Yeah, and then we have one last poll, which has to do with certain areas where we need some improvement, I think. It's just a question of priority. So we have, for example, we have global settings. The global settings have grown very long. As we started with Check-MK, global settings were just a few. Now we have, I think, a couple of hundred global settings. These settings are not always in the perfect order. They're sometimes inconsistent. Here's just an example from the user interface where you can set something about the downtimes in one option and a couple of options later, again, something else about setting downtimes. So I think this needs a cleanup. One idea could be to split the global settings into different modules. And the general question is, do you think we should invest time into the global settings? Next thing is configuration of special agents. As you can see in this screen, this is a special agent where the password is still required to type in, but we have a password save, as you know, or a password store, to be precise. So these configurations are inconsistent. Sometimes you can use the password store, sometimes you can't use it. Sometimes you can configure HTTP proxies, sometimes you can't. So the question is, we could invest time into making this more consistent. Then we have many, many rules. As you know, Check-MK is about rule-based configuration. And this is an example for the rules of the file system monitoring. Of course, file system monitoring started very simply with just one kind of levels, namely the used space in percent. Now we have, I think, is it 12, is it 15 different options here, and every option has sub options. So we have now some of the rules which are really complicated, but they are very important rules, very frequently used rules. So the idea is we could, for example, have this show more, show less thing also apply to the value of such a rule. So that if you, for example, are a beginner, you just would see the levels for the file systems and maybe two or three more. And if you really want to dig in, you press advanced mode and then you get all of the options. And also we would think about a better order and better naming of these options. So this is an example for such a complex file system rule. Then we have a very interesting idea about the page in Check-MK where you manage your host and folders. So some people have many folders. When we designed Check-MK, we thought probably you will have four or five folders in each subfolder, and we invented these large icons just to make a difference to all these tables. But some people have said it's very inconvenient for them to have these icons, because if they have 50 folders, it's very hard to find the correct folder. So we have made a mock-up like this. You have the folders as a list and the host as a list. Our best practice anyway is that you either have host in a folder or have subfolders. So in many situations, you would have just one of these lists. But the really most important improvement would be that we show information about the current folder in this sidebar. For example, we could show attributes that are set in that folder. Because, for example, you have this system of inheritance. And maybe right in the folder, there's a setting we want SNMP monitoring. And it's currently you have to open the properties of the folder to see that. And we could show the attributes that are actually set in that folder, which are not inherited, to display them here to have a better overview. Also, an overview over the rules in that folder and things like that. So it's not yet finalized what kind of numbers we would display here, information, but the idea is that we invest much time in this folder view, which is, I think, one of the most important pages of Check-MK. And last but not least, we have, it's just a small thing, you know, we have this quick search now we have the search in the monitor menu, we have it in the setup menu. We could add this also for the customize menu so that you can quickly search for customized dashboards, views, stuff like that, reports, and so on. So let's start the poll. Just check it out that I start the correct poll. It's this one, okay, so let's let's run that poll. Which of these five things that I've just explained do you think we should invest our time? And now I'm really curious what's happening. And let's have a look. Let's already jump to the so that everybody can see what's going on here. So I think looks like we already have a clear winner here. We have after 120 votes, we have an absolute majority. Yeah, we don't need a coalition. So managing hosts and folders is by far the number one feature. And yeah, I think that, I mean, the global settings are ugly and everything, but you don't need them so often. And the host and folders is really a very important page. I mean, it's a page everyone needs. So yeah, we have 57% of you think that we should invest our time in that. And for me, it's a good outcome. Thanks for your polls. Time is up. We have some questions, but I think we need to postpone these questions to the how many time in 5 minutes the next slot starts already. So let's close the session for now. Thanks for taking part. Our next session will be about give me a hint. The monitoring from the cloud. So Thomas will join me here on the stage. Stay tuned. In a couple of minutes, we continue with the future of cloud monitoring in Czech and K.